Excuse me again, thank you.
Martin, if you will, please.
Good, I was just curious.
Present the case CU 2015-03, Charles Bennett, please.
Mr. Chairman, this is a request for conditional use permit approval for property located at 2891 Home Meadow Drive, in Suburban 15. They are requesting approval for accessory dwelling unit. All a similar request about a year ago, it was for conditional use for accessory dwelling on 15. This is very similar in that the accessory dwelling unit is part of the main dwelling, it's not attached structure.
Hold it, please. Was somebody mic closed those doors for me right there?
Yes, sir, I got it.
This is the accessory dwelling unit that is part of the main dwelling, it's not the attached building like you can see. These used to be called garage apartments with mother-in-law suites. In this case, you have an existing residence that has been remodeled, where a two-car garage has been enclosed, increasing the heated square footage of the floor area. It is now 4,240 square feet of heated space, of which 1,179 is the accessory dwelling, a little more than 3,000 square feet is the main dwelling. In your packet and on the screens, it's a copy of the floor plan. You can see the layout of the different rooms. In effect, the two-car garage has been converted to a master suite and a secondary kitchen. It is the left side or the east side of the house that is a self-contained space could function as its own well. The bedroom, kitchen, living space, its own laundry and water heater, connected only by a doorway into the other dwelling, which is still largely unchanged. The other dwelling is 3 bedrooms and 3.5 baths. This is 1 bedroom and 1 bath. It still would function, at least in terms of appearance from the outside, as 1 dwelling. It just has an extra kitchen and a door to the outside. So by the code, it does meet the definitions for accessory dwelling. There has been a bit of history to this property that is outlined in detail on the cover page. Our permits were pulled starting in January. A lot of work was done in excess of those permits. The permit was to add on to the front porch. The addition to the front porch actually went beyond the scope of the permit and beyond the front setback. Stop work order was issued. Inspection revealed the was extra work to the porch, a multitude of work to the inside without permits. The request was made to the zoning board of appeals to seek relief for the front setback issue. It was denied by zoning board of appeals on September 1st. The applicant did submit architectural drawings, plans for that, for the remodeling work inside the home. Those were reviewed and approved, and all those details are spelled out for you. So the applicant is requesting now for approval of the accessory dwelling within the walls of the original dwelling. In your packet, I think there's a couple pictures. I've added some more in the PowerPoint. This is how the property looked in 2012. It's viewed from the street. Here is the front porch addition that was built. A little bit too large. It encroached about 12 feet into the front setback. Within the past few weeks, the applicant has moved that back to comply with the setback requirements, so that has been completed. Here's the interior shot that was taken back in July. It shows the kitchen that has been added. In your packet is a listing of all supplemental standards for accessory dwellings, and a checklist showing that the applicant does meet all of those standards. On page 2 of your packet is staff's recommendation. In this case, we're finding the character of the building to still be that of single family character. It still very much looks like a single family home as opposed to a duplex or a two-unit dwelling. So staff has found this consistent with our conditional use review criteria and our comprehensive plan number recommend approval to subject to these conditions. Condition number 1. Conditional use approval shall be granted for an attached internal accessory dwelling unit not to exceed 1 bedroom, and as depicted on the submitted floor plan, the dwelling unit shall maintain compliance with all applicable current code requirements for such dwelling units. No Number two, the exterior side entry door for the accessory dwelling unit shall remain a single door, and in porch covering feature over the entryway shall not exceed 6 by 6 feet in area. Number three, the applicant shall obtain proper city approvals and comply with all engineering departmental requirements for the recent driveway and sidewalk improvements. Number four, initial use approval shall expire 2 years if the dwelling unit is not completed and occupied by that date. And going back to number three, we talked about this in the work session, but one of the requirements the applicant has not met is a separate issue where work was done in the city right-of-way, also a major expansion to the driveway. All of these need approval from the city engineering department. They have not yet obtained those approvals. That is currently in process. But regardless of the driveway or work in the right-of-way, what is before you is the accessory dwelling unit issue inside the building itself. If you'd like to answer any questions, you might have to.
Chris Paul, do you know what improvements are inside the pool house?
I looked at the pool house back in July. It was a lot smaller than I thought it would be. It was basically one room, and not very large, with two toilets and a very tiny little back. Basically, it's a pool house. I actually expected to find an accessory dwelling unit there instead of in the main building, but the building, the pool house, is